In another moment, down went Alice after it, never once considering how in the world she was to get out again.
I think we're here.
Key. You must find the key.
Son?
Sir?
Here we go again.
Desmond?
Do you hear us?
Yeah. What happened?
The temple triggered a bleeding effect. You collapsed and entered into a fugue state.
So naturally, you dropped me into the Animus instead of, I don't know, making sure I was okay?
You weren't in any danger. Besides, the temple appeared to be communicating with you, and I didn't want to risk severing the connection. At least not until we knew what it wanted.
Right. Of course.
Son, I...
No, it's fine. I get it. And I know what I'm looking for, by the way. It's a key. Just no idea where it is, though. Guess that's why she triggered the bleeding effect.
She?
Juno, Dad. She's talking to me.
Okay, Desmond. While you were, visiting Constantinople, we picked up a software update for the Animus. I'd like to run a couple of quick tests, make sure there aren't any major issues.
All right. What do you need me to do?
We'll start simple. Walk to the marker over there. Okay, Desmond. Let's practice climbing on these objects. Run your way through this little obstacle course. That's a constraint. These are optional objectives that raise your synchronization rate. All right, Desmond, follow the on-screen instructions and kill the two Templars. All you have to do here is jump the gap. Organization levels look good now. We should be able to build the world. Time to find out what the temple wants from you.
Sir? Sir? Everything all right, sir?
Yes, fine. I'm just preoccupied, that's all.
Don't forget your invitation. Master Birch will be meeting you inside.
Thank you.
Where shall I retrieve you once you're done?
Front of the Opera House. And be quick about it. Don't expect to be here long.
I'll bring her round at once.
Invitation, please. Shall I take your coat, sir?
Ladies and gentlemen, you are requested to kindly find your seats.
Good evening, sir. This way, please.
My apologies.
Evening, Haytham.
Reginald?
I can't tell you how happy I was to hear they'd mounted this revival. Gay's best work by far. Have you seen it before?
Once. My father brought me here as a child. Though I remember little of it. I don't suppose tonight will afford me the luxury of a proper viewing either.
No, I'm afraid it won't. On to business, then. Do you see him?
Be seated in one of the boxes above.
The stairs are watched. You'll need to find another way up.
I already have.
So, Black Maul at St. Word of Trial comes on in the afternoon, and she hopes you will order matters so as to bring her off.
As the wench is very active and industrious.
A thousand pardons. My apologies.
Okay, sir. Is found guilty.
No lazy dog. When I took him the time before, I told him what would come to if he did not bend his hand. This is death without reprieve. I made vegetable. Poor Tom Gag. £40. Let Betty Sly know I'll save her from the confrontation. So I can get more while I stay in England.
Betty has brought more goods into our lock here than any rival again. And in truth, It's a pity to lose so good a customer.
If none of the gang take her on, she might, in the common call subpoenas, live in 12 months longer. I love to let women escape. A good sportsman always let me see it. Partridge's guy was the breed the game depends on. Besides, here the law allows us no reward. There's nothing to be got by the death of women.
Ha!
No why.
State fright.
A little Dutch courage will put a bloom in your cheek.
Come back, taste the music, boy. And let your friends know what I intend. I'd like to make them.
When a gentleman is long kept in suspense, penitence may break his spirit ever after.
Jeremy's really burning up the boards tonight. He's a marvel.
And makes him risk another without fear or scruple. But all the way, it is a pleasure to be the messenger of comfort to friends in affliction.
It is now high time to look about me for a decent execution against next session. I ain't a lazy rogue by whom one...
Hey, Tham. You should have come to me. We would have found another way. Yes. But then you would have known. For what it's worth, I'm sorry.
As am I.
Any weapons?
In the upper balconies.
I beg your pardon.
Did they find the killer?
Please.
Order.
Please.
We must have order.
No.
The man was
killed
up there.
We must have order.
Sir, try to remember.
That's an opera.
Be careful.
I can't get out of here fast enough.
It happened
we
right
must
in that
leave
balcony.
At once.
What are those
There's
men doing
about? About? I'm staying where it's safe.
Order!
Move.
We must
Move.
Have order!
Hey. Imbecile!
Where are you going?
I need to get out. Too close in here. I must get some air. Calm. Right.
And how was the opera?
Rather dull, truth be told.
Shall we be off, then?
Aye. To Fleet and Bride.
By your command.
Fascinating. Gentlemen, I hold in my hand a key, and if this book is to be believed, it will open the doors of a storehouse built by those who came before.
Ah, yes. Those who ruled, reigned, and vanished from the world. Do we know what it is that will be held within?
It could contain certain knowledge, perhaps a weapon, or something as yet unknown, unfathomable in its construction and purpose. It could be any of these things, or none of them. They are still an enigma, these precursors. But of one thing I am certain. Whatever waits behind those doors shall prove a great boon to us all.
Or our enemies, should they find it first.
They won't.
Some fresh air might do me good.
And then all will be well.
Are you sure about that?
Of course. Have I ever led you astray?
Nah. Oh, you don't sit right with the others.
Have faith, my friend. You'll see.
Well, well. Seems our esteemed guest has deigned to grace us with his presence. You might want to head back to your quarters. Top deck's no place for tender Parnells.
So I thought. And yet here you are.
Fancy yourself a joker, eh? Let's see how funny you find this.
That's enough, Graves.
Stay out of this.
Listen to this, Hector. Thinks he can swagger on up here and declare himself king of the castle.
Please, fellas, call this off. If the captain sees
us... The hell with the captain. And to hell with you, Mills! Whose side you on, anyway?
Well, I'm ready to go again if you are.
This is unwise.
Why is that? You think I'm afraid of you?
No. But you should be.
like these odds.
Captain, explain yourself at once, Mr. Kenway.
These thought
we were simply passing the time with a bit of sport, Captain.
How about you pass the time by doing your goddamn jobs instead? I wasn't aware I was paying you to loll about. A word, please, Mr. Kenway.
Oh, I nearly forgot. There's your knife back.